In this block, we will see how to create an OTP screen in our Flutter application. So here we are using a dependency library here, pin underscore entry underscore text underscore field here. So here I am specifying the latest version available 0.1.4, and you can update the version according to the latest available to avoid any issue. So here, starting from void main, here we are considering the default class MyApp, which is extending a stateless widget here. So here we are returning a material app inside which we are considering a home class here. So this home class is extending a stateless widget, and which in turn is returning a scaffold. So inside the scaffold we are providing an app bar. So for the app bar we have providing a title too. So inside the title we are displaying a default message called enter OTP. So here, this particular OTP you might be having at the time of user login or when you are trying to make any payment in your application. So in that particular scenario you may have this OTP useful. So now let us see a default design how we are dealing it in the Flutter application. So inside the body we have considered a center tag, inside which we have considered a container, and we have provided a sufficient padding so that our OTP block comes in the center of the screen. So again, this is a design aspect, you may change it according to your own application requirement here. So here we have provided a padding of 8.0 on all the sides, and here you can see we have provided a child widget which is pin entry text field. So here you can see what are all the parameters available in the pin entry text field here. So when you click control and tap on the widget, you can see the properties available in that particular widget. Here we are having last pin fields, on submit field, field width, font size, and text obscure, show field as box. So here these are all the different parameters we are having. So here we have considered only few fields here. Show field as a box, true. So whenever you are making this parameter as true, so the field will be in the form of a box shape here. And if you make it a false, just you will be finding an underline in the field. So here on submit here, so whenever you have entered the pin, and you can make this particular action call. So here whenever you enter the fourth value, it automatically takes it as a submit here. So here we are trying to display a small alert box whenever you have entered the OTP. So here we are not verifying the OTP, but just we are accepting the user input, and when the user inputs the last digit, then we consider it as a submit action, and then we are trying to display a dialog box here. So here you can see the output. This is how the screen looks like, and this is how the fields in which we are going to enter our OTP. So here let us see what are the options available in this particular library now. So here inside the pin entry text field we are having four fields here. So yes, we are having four fields, and when you enter the last field, you will be making an on submit request here, and here the field width, font size, and text obscure, and show field as box. These are all the different parameters we are having in our OTP input boxes here. So here you can see we have provided show field as box here, true. So this is how you can see the boxes over here. So if you don't want the boxes here, you can just make it to false and try to run it again. So here auto restart may not be working, so just make a run again. So here you can see the boxes are now made into just fields here. So here you can enter your OTP, and on entering the last field, the OTP will be provided here in the form of an alert dialog. So here you can make your own action to be performed. So whenever you have entered the last digit here, you may make the verification and provide the result accordingly, or you can move to another screen. So you can make whatever the action according to your requirement here. So this is how we implement the OTP mechanism in our Flutter application, and the code for this tutorial is available in the description section below. And if you are having any queries, do let me know in the comment section below. And if you like this tutorial, do like, share, and subscribe to our channel for more interesting content on Flutter.